Hi students, good morning. Hope all of you are safe and healthy at home. I am P. Sharda, JL Zoology, working at Telangana Social Welfare Residential College, Narsingi. Students, look at this picture. Who is he? You might not be knowing. Your answer might be a baby or a small kid. Students, see, there are some objects lying on the table. Suppose I ask you to get one. So which one will you get? Again, there will be a big confusion. Okay. When I asked you to pick one thing from the table, you were in a big confusion because I have not specified the object name. If I would have said, get a pen, you will be easily get it. In the same way, when I have shown you the picture, you are not able to identify the baby in the picture because you don't know his name. Suppose I tell you his name, you will be able to identify. So it means naming is very, very important. So naming an object or an animal or a plant or an organism is called as nomenclature. So today's our topic is nomenclature. So nomenclature means naming a plant, animal or any object. So worldwide, approximately there are 1.7 to 1 point million species were known and they are called by their local names. So these names vary from place to place. For example, let us see this. What is this? This is a brinjal. This is brinjal. Suppose I ask you in Telugu, this is called as vankaya. Suppose I ask, what is the name in Hindi? You can say bangal. In Tamil, it is called as kathrikai. So that means here in three different areas, this brinjal is called with three different names. In the same way, see here. This is a horse. What do you call it in Hindi? Ghoda. Then in Telugu, it is Gurramu. In English, horse. Then, do you know what is the scientific name of it? The scientific name of horse is Equus Tabas. If you call with the scientific names, for example, let us take the brinjal. So the scientific name of a brinjal is Solanum melangina. In the same way, the scientific name of horse is Equus caballus. Suppose you call with these names, even a biologist throughout the globe will understand. That means there should be a standardization of naming pattern. So this is followed by nomenclature. So before naming an organism, there is must of identifying that organism. So you have to identify the structure, the features of an organism, then only you will be able to name. And these naming pattern should be acceptable throughout the globe. So that's why it has a name which is same throughout the globe or universally. So nomenclature is having naming an organism with a scientific name or a distinctive name. So this nomenclature follows the guidelines of ICZN. ICZN means International Code for Zoological Nomenclature. So this helps in naming the animals. So in the same way, there is another condition, or you can say there is another organization which will help to name the plants, that is ICBN, that is International Code for Botanical Nomenclature. Okay, today in our topic we learned about naming of organisms, that is nomenclature. So nomenclature is of three types which we are going to learn in our next session. So before that, you just prepare with binomial nomenclature, trinomial and polynomial nomenclature. Come prepare with those topics. Thank you.